This show is part of the RetroZap.com podcast network.
Hello, I'm Jack McKenzie. I played Cal Alder, the deck lieutenant rebel forces from Echo Base in Episode 5, Star Wars Episode 5, The Empire Strikes Back. And I'd like to say that all the patrols are in. Still no contact from Chris or Joe. You're listening to Brews and Blasters. Have a nice day.
Here we go.
You're listening to Brews and Blasters. The Star Wars party starts now.
How are we doing?
Same as always.
That bad, huh?
Pokey religions and ancient weapons are no match for a good blaster at your side, kid.
Let us go inside where we can discuss business over a drink.
Did you join us for a little refreshment?
Everyone's invited, of course.
With Chris Salton and Joe Tavano, two guys from Boston, who are talking about this stuff anyway.
Whoa.
Let him marinate with like a good steak tip.
Oh yeah.
Renegades. We're having a nice time.
We just got a cup of super cold zippy sip.
Yes. We had a barbecue. Society.
Okay, Star Wars.
With that guy. Dangerous.
What's up, Warheads? It is episode 9, Night of Brews and Blasters. We're going to talk about what we know, what we don't know, and what we want to know. Plenty there. We'll talk about it later. Just before we started, we were talking about it. We need some Willow 6-inch action figures. Oh, here we go. Oh, my gosh. Right in the middle of my words.
It smells so good.
It's lemon. Lemon seltzer.
Gotta love the lemon.
Wow. All right. I guess we're doing a sippy sip early here. Drink up.
Remember you started chugging and I tried catching up to you, but you lost it?
Yeah, it choked. That was like 2 weeks ago. Or 3 weeks ago. Madonna me.
Yeah, we're talking about Willow action figures.
Yeah, we need them. We need 6-inch Willow action. How good would that be?
6-inch? Even 3.75s.
We need 6-inch.
Well, what I was getting with the 3.75s, we have that Weasel figure now. Is it Weasel or Weasel?
Weasel.
Weasel, okay. Weasel. Let's keep it nice and simple. It's the Weasel.
Buddy. The
Weasel.
Yeah. Big shout out, Pauly Shore. Boom.
Love that dude.
Love him.
So we could pull off that head and put the, you know, Warwick Davis head on there.
Sure. Let's do that. Or let's just do 6-inch figures. We could do one wave. That's all you really need.
Yeah. People are going to buy it.
I would buy it. I'll buy six cases.
I'm going to buy. You know what's funny? You know how my brother hates all of this stuff? He'll buy a Willow figure.
I'll go down to the movie theaters. I'll sell them. I don't care.
I'll never forget when we met Warwick Davis. Yeah. And I was in line. And my brother... We're in Disney. That's like his realm, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And he's walking by and he was like, "You're going to meet Willow? Oh my God, that's Willow."
Yeah, Willow.
And I was like, see, if you woke up early, you could be meeting him with me.
Yeah, yeah.
But you had to have your Mickey Mouse pancakes.
All right, all right. Wave, you could literally do one wave. Willow, okay. You could do Mad Mardigan.
That has to happen, yeah. Yeah.
Who's the girl hero?
Oh, I forget her name.
I forget her name, the redhead one.
Two-pack little rat guys.
Oh, hold on. We got to get the big...
Skull-faced man.
Yes, General Kang.
Yeah, he's a really old, ugly man.
Yeah.
With a really cool skull helmet.
Yeah, that he's unbelievable. We need that figure. That's unbelievable. Bav Morta. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Eric.
Oh, dude, the wizard.
I got it. The two wizards. We need the Daikini wizard.
Yeah.
And then we need not Alora Dannon, the other lady, the witch.
She's like a goat or something.
Yeah. And then they turn her into the old lady.
Yeah.
Yeah. We need her. And then we need what's it called? To round it out. Who's the last person we need? We need Alora Dannon. You know? You could do Alora Dannon and the pixie people.
And you can do like a deluxe pack and do that two-headed dragon thing.
Oh my God. We could do Alora Dannon and the pixie people. I stole the baby, that guy.
Oh yeah.
I'll do them. And then for the big creature, you do the two-headed dragon bear thing.
Done.
Done. We got the wave. Ship it. Let's go.
We'll buy it. There's a $1.25 right there.
I'll sell it for you. You make it, I'll sell it. We're all good here. Hey, guys. Welcome to Brews and Blasters. This is what we do. We're called the Star Wars Party, and for good reason, we're often imitated, never replicated. That's true. Thank you for being here. And if you're first time listening, we're sorry.
We're sorry.
Yeah, we try.
Sorry.
Chris, I need to know one thing. When does the Star Wars Party begin?
Oh, no.
Yeah. It's true. We're partying. We have some seltzers here.
We have some seltzers.
We're having some seltzers. We have a little Coronas here.
We have lemon. What do you have?
I got a Cape Cod cranberry.
Dude, that sounds amazing.
It is amazing. All cranberries are really Cape Cod.
I think there might be one over there.
There might be one there. Yeah.
Dibs.
I stole the cranberry. You ever listen to Willowcast, Brews and Willow?
Yeah, Brews and Willow.
We've already done a Willow commentary, guys. It's secret.
Oh, oh my God, we did.
We did.
Yeah, we did.
2015.
It's episode 8?
No, it's not. It's not episode 8.
I don't even know what episode this is.
It's 176.
See?
Yeah, number 176.
You're not just another pretty face, Joe. You know?
This face is made for radio, my friends. Trust me. Trust me on that. Oh, man.
So we're drinking. We got our drinky poos.
Yeah, it's been, we're coming off a little hiatus, and then we had a little tiny hiatus there.
Yeah, we did. We did.
Yeah, babies.
How you been?
Yeah, it turns out babies don't really care about podcast recording schedules.
No,
but it's all right,
Boss baby.
Yeah, they're out the boss.
They run the show. That's it.
Yeah, she's a baby genius.
She's a baby.
So everyone's doing good, though. Gotta be honest.
Everyone's good.
Yeah, having a good time. Feeling the flow.
How are you?
How are you? How are you?
I just ate dinner.
We can't do that. We already did that. We already did the Frank Sinatra episode.
Did we do it
episode.
Or did we text it? Because the next day we were texting.
we were texting Frank Sinatra. No. Last episode we were literally singing Frank Sinatra the entire time.
You know what's funny is I was telling old man Mike about that like the next morning. And he just gave me this look of like he's smiling, but he also thinks I'm stupid.
Yep.
You know, like, I don't know what you thought. I'm like, Mike, I just ate dinner. And he's like, you're a moron.
And yeah, that's
hey,
great.
How you doing? Chris and Joe, two morons here.
Hey, no, it's good. So I've been telling you, the baby's been falling asleep to Baby Wars every night. She loves it.
Yeah.
Okay. All of a sudden, what shows up to my wondering eyes, what appears, Baby Wars Volume 2.
Now, is this brand new?
Brand new. Just came out. Just showed up in the feed, so to speak. So we're checking it out. We're on Spotify. Check out what we got on Baby Wars Volume 2. We got Duel of the Fates. Oh yeah. I mean, it's a little aggressive for a lullaby.
Are you sure that's Duel of Fates or NeedEm, Gotem?
NeedEm, Gotem, NeedEm, Gotem, NeedEm, Gotem, NeedEm.
Need them.
There's some good stuff in here. There's some really deep cuts, you know. The Meadow Picnic from Star Wars. We're going episode 2 on this.
Do they have like the celebration music at the end?
Oh, like good good time band, parade, marching band.
Yeah.
I don't...
All the Gungans, they're like... yeah, they're playing drums and stuff.
No, he hasn't done that one. Anakin's Betrayal. Ooh. Okay, very sad.
Yeah, this is sad.
Yeah. Rey's theme.
Oh.
Not bad, because this is almost a little lullaby-ish the way John Williams composed it with the Celeste. Pretty cool. So I like how he's going into sequel trilogy stuff, too, here.
This guy's onto something.
Yeah, you know how I knew it. All right. The Star Killer. Here's my favorite, March of the Resistance. I'm putting the baby to bed. I'm like just stomping around.
It's like, Joe, why are you sweating?
I'm holding her very, very calmly, but like my feet are like going crazy.
Yeah.
Here come the resistance! Yeah! Yeah, pretty good. Torn Apart. I think this is episode 3 as well. Oh, no, no, this is Force Awakens. You were tearing me apart, like Kylo Ren. Talking to,
Yeah, some of these are hard. Father. Like, you have to wait for like 30 seconds to go by.
Here we go. Peace and Purpose. This is Luke's Last Stand and Last Jedi. They're not like kind of in there with us, you know? They're not burned in our brains yet. But you know what? This is smart because this generation, it will be.
Yeah, because then maybe if you play this enough, when she's like 5 and you stop playing the movie, she'll be like, wait, whoa, whoa.
These are the these are the movies they're going to grow up with too. So this will be there.
Yeah.
You know, it's pretty good. Very nice. Yeah. So we get the deep cuts in volume 2. I'm really glad he did it.
Good stuff here.
Yeah. And then the Imperial Suite from Rogue One.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Good not stuff. Bad. Rogue.
Rogue.
Rogue One.
Rogue One. Yeah. Not. You don't see people covering this a lot. Not bad, huh? We're recording. Yeah, so I dig it, you know? It's good stuff. I'm still a little... She's a more of a fan of Volume 1, but this is the nice deep cuts. You got to mix it up once in a while.
Yeah, you got to, like, shuffle that in.
Yeah, yeah. So that's been my life. How's your life?
Life is great, you know, really busy.
You saw The Predator?
I saw The Predator movie. I really can't say much about it.
Thumbs up, thumbs down.
Well, thumbs in the middle. How about that?
Mm.
You know, because this is the thing. Like, I enjoyed it for what it was.
Yeah. Would listeners of this show enjoy it?
I hope so. I enjoyed it.
All
like right. I left the movie theater going, that was a good movie. It wasn't great though.
Okay, not a great movie. It wasn't.
I felt like it had crazy potential to be great, but then I don't know what happened.
Was it better than Predators?
See, this is the thing. I really enjoyed Predators.
I know that. I did too. It was pretty good.
You know. I see. I can't say too much because I don't want to ruin anything.
Just tell me if it was better than Predators. Chris is like sweating right now, making him sweat.
Well, man, I don't know.
Was it better than Predator 2?
No.
Okay. Okay. All right. Clearly. All right.
I was like, "What are you? What?" No, it was like fighting words. I was like, "What are you talking about?"
See, a lot of people. What if you hit me with lightning right now? A lot of people not a huge fan of Predator 2. I loved it.
I don't get it, dude. Concrete Jungle. Let's go.
Let's go.
Danny Glover. Bill Paxton. Let's go.
We're in sync. We're in sync right there.
It was good stuff, man. I like that
great
movie.
Great stuff. Yeah. You know, he was worthy.
Yeah.
All the Predators at the end. You kidding me?
That was awesome.
That was amazing.
That was really cool.
Giving him the
pirate
knife.
Gun.
Yeah, here you go. I thought it was a knife. Whatever.
I think it's one of those like old school like one shooters.
Oh yeah.
It's like this long gun like you would see in like Pirates of the Caribbean.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We pulled this off one of them.
Yeah, and the Predator looked like super old, and he was like, "Take it."
Let's go. You're watch like, that.
Cool.
Let's just shut this down and watch Predator 2.
Yeah, I don't know why that got a bad rap because that was a cool movie. The Predator looked great
because it wasn't Arnold. That's why. People wanted Arnold.
Yeah, Arnold's the best.
Yeah. They wanted more Dutch fighting the Predator.
Well, I mean, that's what happens with a movie like that. The first Predator was so epic. Like, you can't outdo that one.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. It would have been cool, like, if they, when they merged Aliens and Predator, what they should have done is brought John Dutch Vander, not true. John Dutch Vander is in Star Wars. I'm looking at Dutch.
Dutch, yeah.
He doesn't have a name. Just Dutch.
I'm sure he does, but I call him Dutch.
It's Dutch. That's what it is.
Yeah.
I'm looking at his figure right here. We have him right on the wall. Jungle Extraction Dutch.
I got that figure in New Jersey at Monster Mania.
There we go.
I couldn't find it anywhere. And then I go to a monster show and I go, hey, there he is, $20.
There we go. Because he is a monster. He's the best.
Yeah.
But, all right. So they bring back John. I keep on calling him John Dutch Vander. I think his name was John in that movie. Well, I don't know, whatever. They bring back Dutch. They revive him out of, like, cryogenic freezing in the future. He's a space marine from Aliens, and he's off to fight the aliens and predators. Hey. Hey. But what am I doing here? What am I doing? Is that not a great idea for a movie?
They're never clear about the time. But in this movie, I will say they keep referring to 87 and 97.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking because Shane Black, you know, wrote and directed. Yeah. Well, directed at least. I don't
97?
Know. Well, you know,
it was like 92.
Well, they said 87, 97. Maybe they're just like doing it for easy math.
Different events. 87 was the original Predator. But still, like, what if that, like, that would have been an amazing movie. They bring back Dutch, but he's a space marine instead of, like, you know, a merc.
So it would take place in the future.
In the future, in the aliens timeline. But he's a space marine in Aliens.
He wakes up and he's like, I wanted to be retired.
Yeah.
What am I doing here?
What am I doing? But now he's fighting alongside Michael Biehn. He's a space marine.
You know what they should do?
And he's fighting the aliens and the predators. I mean, come on. How did that movie not happen?
They should just make the Alien 3.
Yeah.
Like, you know, the sequel to Alien 2.
Yeah.
The one that we wanted to see.
Yeah, but that's it. Yeah. But that's it. We get Dutch from Predator, come back, space marines fighting aliens and predators.
He's like, hey, we did Terminator together. Yeah. You remember me? Oh my gosh, that would have been amazing.
How did that not happen? How did that not happen? I'm shutting everything down. I'm walking away. Oh, I don't know what to do here. How did that not happen?
Well, I'm that's
angry.
What happened.
I'm angry now.
All these guys that were making the movies at the same time, it was a crew. You know, like they all work together. Kind of just like 90s movies.
Yeah.
It's like always the same
like Judd Apatow movies.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Seth Rogen, Jonah Hill, Danny McBride, Paul Rudd, Jason Segel.
Hey, Danny McBride wrote the new Predator movie.
Danny McBride did?
Danny McBride.
Are you sure?
I am sure. Yes.
Because I've been watching a lot of, because I, after seeing the movie, I want to hear what other people thought about it.
Mm-hmm.
And no one has mentioned him.
Oh, yeah. He's involved.
And I love Danny McBride. I just watched his movie Arizona.
Man, oh, yeah. Was that good?
It's crazy.
I heard it wasn't great.
Well, it's definitely like straight to DVD movie.
Uh-huh.
But it keeps you on your toes. I'll say that much.
All right.
It's not the Danny McBride that we're used to.
Yeah, yeah. It's a serious one.
Yeah.
Okay, so apparently I'm wrong.
Well,
How did I think that?
Well, there's another McBride that does writing because when I was watching Underworld, there's a McBride that wrote, and it wasn't Danny McBride.
Yeah, but how did I think that? I don't know why I thought that, but whatever. I'm an idiot.
No, I mean you've probably just seen it somewhere. He's a very busy guy.
He is.
You know,
he's an amazing guy. He's my hero.
Yeah. But like I said, I mean, I'll give it some more time, and then we could like really talk about Predator because I'm sure. There's a lot of people that want to see it but haven't got around to it.
This is what I'm saying. I'm sorry. I got my movies confused. He wrote the new Halloween that's coming out.
Yeah, he did because I follow him on Instagram and he's like really pushing it.
That's what I'm thinking. Yeah. I'm a dum-dum. Sorry, guys.
It actually looks scary.
It looks good. See, that's what they did. Like, remember we were talking about the Alien 3 they should have made?
Yeah.
That's what they're doing with Halloween. This is like the Halloween sequel they should have made.
Right.
Even though I love Halloween 3. Don't get me wrong. It's just a weird movie. Weird movie. Have you ever seen it?
Halloween 3?
Yeah, Season of the Witch.
No.
It's a weird movie, dude. There's not even Michael Myers isn't even in it.
What?
Yeah.
Creepy. I'm not a huge fan of like horror movies.
Yeah.
You know, I mean I watched a couple here and there, but I'm not like
Well, this is the season for me. I do my zombie-thon.
Yeah, you
I try to watch a zombie movie a night.
You and your wife love horror movies.
She loves more like the human suffering movies, you know? I like more like the supernatural stuff. I like the zombies and like, you know, the creepy stuff.
So yeah, you like the stuff that it could never happen. Yeah, she likes the stuff like, oh my god, if you go to a weird place, this could happen.
Yeah, like a dark street, like, oh my god, you know. Yeah. Yeah.
Which is a lot more terrifying.
That terrifies me.
Because I'm pretty sure a killer clown from outer space isn't going to come around, try to kill you with a cotton candy ray gun, and then you break his nose to kill him.
That would be hilarious.
It's not going to happen, though.
No, not going to happen.
That's why it makes it a goofy movie.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. But, like, yeah, we like two different types of horror movies. But then she watches The Walking Dead and says, it's too sad for her. I don't understand.
I'm pretty... Dude, is this Walking Dead gonna end?
No, never. Episode 9.
I was gonna say, I think we have them nice and primed.
Yeah.
Time to talk some Star Wars.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Episode
9-er.
9.
9. It's gonna be nice.
It is gonna be nice.
Yeah.
I can't wait. We get a lot to talk about here.
We do.
But... the movie is being filmed right now. We don't know anything.
Yeah.
But there's a lot to break down already, and I'm getting pumped already. You know, we're almost a year out. It's going to be... We're in a little bit of a slow time, believe it or not.
We're in TV time right now.
Yeah, it's true.
This is what it's going to be like about a year.
That's very astute of you. Yeah. It's true. We're in TV time. We haven't had that with Star Wars, I don't know, since, like, 2014. You know?
Oh, wow, yeah. You know, right? It's weird to say that. Time's really flying.
Since, like, no, I would say this all, the hype really kicked up, like, November 2014 when we got the Black Friday trailer for The Force Awakens.
Yeah.
You know? That's when things kicked into high gear. Also, right around the time Brews and Blasters started.
Yeah.
You know? But that's really when things really kind of kicked into high gear. Before that, we were just like, you know, Star Wars, the hardcore, just we talked amongst ourselves.
We did, yeah.
Yeah. So this is kind of a lean time right now. Resistance is going to come out. It's going to be, I'm sure it's going to be great. I'm really excited to watch it. But, I mean, it's not a film. It's not going to be, I don't know if this first season is going to be like this monumentous event. I don't know. I have high hopes for it, but we'll see how it goes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and it'll run its course, and then we're still going to have a good year.
Yeah.
Before we get really any new Star Wars content on the screen. So we get some time, you know?
Yeah. And you know, in the midst of that, maybe they're going to announce another standalone movie. I don't know.
I hope we get some announcements. I don't know what's going to happen.
I'm dying to know more about Jon Favreau's project and, what's going on with that?
I'll make a prediction with you right now. I think that because we're recording tonight...
Oh, tomorrow, yeah.
Tomorrow we'll get the Episode 9 title, and we'll get a bunch of information about Episode 9.
This happens all the time.
Yeah. Every time there's a major announcement, it's the day after we record.
Yeah. I usually get a text from you around like 9:30, 10 o'clock saying, it happened again.
And there's a lot of swears. Yeah. There are a lot of swears.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we're from Boston, you know?
Yeah, it's true. Have you guys... did you know? It's true.
But yeah, I mean, I just kind of want to hang out with John.
Yeah.
I feel like we would really kick it off.
Exactly. But, you know, Episode 9 is not John Favreau. We're talking about J.J. Abrams.
J.J. Abrams.
He's back. He's replacing Colin Trevorrow, who did a bunch of pre-production on the movie. I don't know how much of that is going to make it through. I think it all got scrapped, to be honest with
you. Right, that's the dinosaur guy, right? Jurassic Park guy?
Yeah, he's the Jurassic Park guy. Yes. The dinosaur guy.
Yeah, but I'm really happy that JJ's back, closing it out. You know, it's going to be fantastic. You know, they're already lining up the cast very well with the new cast.
We'll get to the cast.
Yeah.
But let's think about this. So we had JJ Abrams. He set a lot of things up. He handed it off to Rian Johnson with not a lot of direction. Okay. So Rian Johnson went and made his movie, took things where he thought they should go. Now JJ Abrams is coming back. And to close out the story, I'm not going to say he's going to reverse things that Rian Johnson did, but I think that there's going to be a through line. And I like that. I like that he's going to take up the pieces from The Force Awakens, take the pieces from The Last Jedi, carry it forward into a new movie, and see the thing through.
Yeah, because you're going to take some stuff from those two movies and build on that.
Yeah.
And it's going to be really cool because I really feel like we're going to see the Knights of Ren. Because
I hope so.
I feel
it's
like,
about time.
Well, really think about it. We have Kylo Ren is the supreme leader now.
It's true.
You know, and he needs his crew, I feel like. He needs his guards or whatever, you know?
At least we'll find out what happened to them.
Right,
if exactly. they're not around.
Yeah, because Emperor had the royal guards. Snoke had the Praetorian guards. Like, Kylo has Knights of Ren. I don't know. You know.
Well, let's be honest. The first two movies happened back to back. If the Knights of Ren were out doing something when all this went down, there's ample time for them to enter the picture again.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Well, maybe, Snoke sent them off, like, doing... You know, go to this planet and destroy. Go wreak havoc over here. Yeah. I don't know.
Who knows? They'll figure it out.
Well, it's going to be the same thing with where was Snap Wexley and all of them.
They explain that in the Poe Dameron comic, which is ending, actually. Okay. Yeah, they did explain that. So right after The Force Awakens ended, Leia sent Black Squadron off to try and get more people to rally to the cause.
Now, not to cut you off, but was... Just Pava with Snap Wexley.
Yes.
So she'll be in the new movie.
You should read the books.
We're gonna try to pull it out of her. We're gonna be meeting her at Rhode Island Comic Con.
Oh, we are. That's right.
Yes, sirs.
Yes. Rhode Island Comic Con is coming up, and it's gonna be a banger.
Yeah, it's like November. We're like 40-something days away,
dude. There are people. I'm not usually like a big meet and greet type of guy. There's a lot of people who want to be at Rhode Island Comic Con.
Yeah. I mean, guys, if you're in the area, it's a huge convention. Tons of people going. And yours truly, Brews and Blasters, will be there.
We'll be there. We're there every year. Yeah. You know us. You love us. Come say hi.
We're staples.
Yeah. We're staples of the con. It's a really good show. It's a dark horse, though. No, not a lot of people know about it. I feel like on like the main convention circuit, but it's always packed.
Yeah, it's going to be a good one. Tim Curry's going to be there.
Yeah.
Which is pretty cool. He voiced Palpatine in the Clone Wars. Not all the way through because Abercrombie did that.
That's true. Ian Abercrombie did. But Jim Carrey did a lot.
He did. Like, I don't know what season he took over. But
he took over in the last season, but I think he also closed out season 6, too. And maybe we'll see him again in the new episodes.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
That's right. Yeah. We'll get another season coming. So.
I know.
Who else is going to be there?
Danny Trejo, Ron Perlman.
Yeah, Ron Perlman.
A lot of Marina Baccarin's gonna be there.
Oh, Alan Tudyk.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of these people are around for a long time.
Hey, you know who I might take a picture with is, what's her name?
Ric Flair?
No. We should go, woo!
Finn Jones is gonna be there. I gotta tell you, I love Iron Fist. I don't care what anyone says.
I never seen it.
Iron Fist is really good.
One of your
good.
Hobbits are gonna be there.
Dude, I know. I love it. Billy Boyd.
Yeah.
Yep, played Pippin. There we go. A bunch of wrestlers going to be there. You know, a bunch of people from The Office are going to be there, and I'm really excited about that.
This con has a very all-over-the-place guest list.
It's true.
You know, there's really no rhyme or reason to this.
Mm-hmm. Some people from The Terminator,
There are a couple of people. Oh my God, I can't even speak. There are a couple of people that I would like to take pictures with, but I want to take a picture, like go up to their table, do a quick one. Like, I don't want to do like the, hey, it's $60. Like,
yeah.
I want to be like 20, take a picture. Cool.
Well, you know, who's also going to be there? Rob Liefeld is going to be there. The comic creator.
Oh, right. Yeah.
I'm really
excited about that.
I'm excited about that. He's a pretty cool dude. I mean, I grew up reading his books and loving his art, so I think it'll be a really good... I would like to meet him, I think.
Well, basically, everybody from Deadpool is there except for Ryan Reynolds.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, like the main cast of people. You know, the chick.
But we said Marina Baccarin.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's going to be good. There's some good people lined up. You know, a bunch of people from The Office are going to be there. I'm really excited to meet Creed from The Office. Yeah, he's going to be there. It's pretty cool, man.
They smell like death, but they're delicious.
Mung beans. Oh yeah, it should be good. So yeah, we're gonna be there right on Comic Con. You gotta come out.
Yeah, it's gonna be a good one.
Yeah, definitely.
Hello, my name is Temmie, and I play Tamiri Black in The Last Jedi. You're listening to Brews and Blasters.
All right, episode 9.
Back to episode 9. So I wonder if Brimboy is going to be in it.
I don't think so.
Yeah, I love that he recorded that, even though he can't have a brew yet.
Right, exactly, yeah.
That was awesome.
He can have like a root beer.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, have a root. That's true.
Or Doles.
One of that good sarsaparillas.
Yeah, sarsaparilla.
Yeah. You know, I wonder if they're going to take that forward. I think this movie is going to be further on in the future. You know, I think we're going to have a nice time jump.
Like, how many years?
Five?
Ten?
5 to 10, I think. I think so. I think Rey's going to be in a pretty powerful Jedi at that point. She's been studying the ancient Jedi texts. I think she's going to be studying those.
Page turners.
Yeah, not really.
Yeah.
But I also think she's going to be, you know, kind of following her heart, too, and learning from that.
Yeah, do you think, like, there's going to be any love interest in this movie?
I don't know.
Because, you know, like, when she meets Poe, he's like, hey, I'm... All right. I'm Poe Dameron.
He really
does that. Best pilot in the galaxy.
Like, hey, I'm Poe Dameron. Like, she's like, I know.
She's like, I have crazy force powers.
Yeah.
He's like, I was born underneath the force tree.
Yeah.
Hey.
Now, also in the comics, there's a whole book that talk, like, they're all on the Falcon talking.
Oh, cool.
Like, it's Poe, Rey, and Finn, and they're all like kind of catching up on what the hell happened.
Yeah.
You know, they're like, whoa, you were there? What, that happened to you? That's crazy. And, you know, like, all three of them, like, catch up on a bunch of stuff. It's pretty cool.
Oh, that is pretty cool.
Yeah, definitely. So, a lot of good stuff's been happening in the Poe Dameron comic for the past couple issues, for sure. It's been a great series altogether.
Do you know how many more until it ends, or is it just, like, ending soon?
It's I think it just ended.
Oh, wow.
I don't know. I'm not sure if the last issue has already come out yet, but it's ending very soon.
Okay.
Like, there's only one more issue out. So
they got some juicy stuff in there.
Definitely worth a read, for sure. I think it's only like maybe 30 issues,
right?
You know, total, maybe less. But yeah, I forget off the top of my head. But no, it's pretty good. So this, I don't know if there's gonna be a love interest or not. I don't know. I mean, they're at war, right. So I don't know how much time you have. No time for love, Dr. Jones.
It would be really cool to see Hayden as a Force ghost.
Yeah,
we're definitely gonna see Luke. As a Force ghost.
Like, do you think Luke is going to be a Force ghost? Do you think maybe he's going to come back like full body?
No, I think he's going to be like a Force ghost, but not like blue Force ghost. Like, you know when...
All right, let's take this through. A New Hope. You only get a voice. All right, well, I'm even going to go back further. Episode 2. You only get a voice. You know, and Yoda's in deep meditation to hear that. Okay? Clone Wars. You get a Force ghost of Qui-Gon only on Mortis, because it's a nexus of power. Then you get him in little sparkles after that on the Force planet, but he can't really come back fully, right? He teaches this to Yoda. Yoda teaches this to Obi-Wan. Obi-Wan dies, can only really do what Qui-Gon can do, yeah. The voice and stuff.
Run!
Yeah. Run, Luke, run! Yeah, and he can basically only do that, all right? Episode 5, he can come back fully. He can come back as a ghost, but he's still very, like, you know...
Well, I was going to say, Jedi?
By Jedi, he's sitting on a log, he's pushing trees away.
He just has, like, this glow to him.
Yeah.
You know, but his like, body is
he's
there.
He's sitting on a log.
But he is translucent, though.
He is a little translucent. Not as much as he was in Empire Strikes Back, though.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not talking blue ghost spirit.
Yeah.
Like the Kenner figure.
Yeah, no. Not like that at all.
Was that Kenner or Hasbro at the time, that three-pack? You know, the ghosts, the spirits, all three of them?
I don't know. I think it was Hasbro.
Yeah. You guys know what we're talking about.
By Return of the Jedi, you got all three of them standing there. You got Obi-Wan, you got Yoda, and you even have Hayden Anakin.
Right.
Okay? So, you got a lot going on. And it almost felt like you know, you had, like, Obi-Wan and Yoda, and then they kind of, like, pulled Anakin back. They're like, yeah, get over here.
Yeah.
Because you came in afterwards, you know? Like, yeah, get over here, you. You know? We need you. Yeah.
Well, just like in the Last Jedi, too, like, Yoda.
Yeah.
I mean, he looked like he was there, too.
You get to The Last Jedi now, all right? And, yeah, there was a glow, but he's able to actually use the Force to make things happen in the real world. That's crazy. He's able to call lightning down.
Yeah.
He's, you know, he hits Luke. He hits Luke with his stick.
Yep.
He's interacting with people. How much further are they going to take this? I think that Luke is going to literally be able to come back full body and, like, lightsaber battles, like, just hang out, be a dude, you know?
Well, that would be a first, lightsaber battle.
I know that. I know that.
Do you think they're going to go that route?
I think Luke is going to have the grand send-off that everyone was screaming he should have had in The Last Jedi. You know? But everyone forgets it's the middle film. It's not the end film.
Right, right.
This is going to be the glorious triumph of the Skywalker saga.
Yeah, I mean, he did say, I'll see you around.
I'll see you around, kid.
Yeah.
And you know what he also said? He's going to haunt Kylo Ren just like his father does.
Mm. What does that mean?
Does Kylo... All right. Kylo Ren's talking to this mask, saying, show me the power of the dark side, as if he saw Anakin or some dark side ghost of Darth Vader, right? I know they don't do force ghosts on the dark side, but there's something there. There's some spirit essence left that he communed with. What if, you know, you get that? What if you get, you know, I don't know. What if you get Harrison? Some sort of, like, what if he's able to tap into the some sort of force ghost of Han Solo as well? Do you think they're going to pull Harrison back?
No.
I think it might be on the table. I think there might be something on the table.
If anything, I can see a flashback of maybe like the teenage years.
I think he's
like
haunted.
What happened.
I think there's something haunting him. I think we're going to see Harrison say something really, you know, really powerful to Kylo Ren. You know, like, I love you. I forgive you. Please come back. Please come back to the light.
I don't know.
I think he's going to do it. You have to come back to the light, you know? Not all hope is lost. I think we're going to see something, and it's going to be a mic dropper. I think it's going to be like, wow. You know, done in secret. No one telling no one. Maybe one or two lines.
I don't know. I could definitely see the flashback because they've been doing that.
Yeah, yeah. But is that going to make anyone, like, jaw drop? I think we're going to see, from Kylo Ren's point of view, he's actually being haunted. What is this call to the light? What is this call to the light?
How about a dream sequence? Because that would make more sense. Because Harris, him being any kind of a ghost.
Not a force ghost.
I don't, you know what I mean? Like,
not a force ghost, just something else. You know? You know, maybe he's meditating and he sees him. You know? Maybe Harrison, you know, maybe like in Kylo Ren's meditation, he sees and hears, you know, Han Solo forgiving him. Something. All he's saying throughout the entire two films that we've seen is that the call to the light is splitting him in two, and killing his father made it even worse.
Right.
That's all we know. So I think there's something there. You know? I think that would be crazy.
Yeah, I
total
mean...
total speculation on my part.
I'm dying to see this story. I'm dying to see what they're doing with Carrie Fisher, how that's going to play out.
There's more footage, you know? Exactly. They're bringing her back using unused footage. What if they already filmed the Harrison scenes? What if J.J. Abrams has been holding on to them?
Well, that's the thing, too. I've been thinking about the scenes that they have for Carrie Fisher, right?
Yeah.
Now, did she have, like, other dresses that she used that just got cut out?
Apparently. We know there were a lot of things that were dropped. You know, remember there was that scene of Maz Kanata handing the lightsaber to Leia?
Yeah.
I mean, there's other stuff that she was in.
Right.
To Leia. There was a shot in one of the trailers where Maz Kanata...
Oh, you're right. Yeah. It was like the first trailer. But it was just hands.
It was just hands, but we could tell who it was.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, there's stuff around they're going to be picking up and using. I mean, I'm excited for it. I'm really excited that Carrie Fisher is going to be there.
Yeah, me too.
So, definitely. What other surprises are we going to get? We're going to get something new. We're going to get some new stuff. I think Rey is going to blow our minds with what she's able to do with the Force. You know? I would love to see her bring back the Force speed that, like, Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan were able to use.
Okay.
You know? Because we never saw that again. You know? You know? It's a... Remember? It's
yeah,
a,
with the
droidicas.
Yeah, yeah, the destroyers.
Yeah.
And they were like...
Phew! Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. At the stalemate. And they just ran off.
I'm yeah.
Like, what? It was crazy.
And they were like, where'd they go?
Master destroyers. Oh, that's so awesome. Yeah. So, a lot there. Let's talk about the cast. Because we've had some announcements.
Yeah.
There's been a lot going on. All right. So, we got Daisley Ridley, Adam Driver, John Boyega, Oscar Isaac, Lupita Nyong'o, who's going to be coming back.
Nice.
You know? Pretty exciting.
Hopefully in body. You know,
yeah, not
in
just,
like
not
a transmission.
A hologram,
yeah.
You know, I think there's going to be more for her to do.
Yeah, I mean, very interesting character. I think definitely
she's older than Yoda. Let's you know.
Yeah, they can find something for her, you know.
They, you know, I think she's going to have something to do with rebuilding the rebellion.
Well, it would be funny because they're like, she's like, hey, you guys owe me a castle. You know, I lived there for a really long time. You guys came for a drink and then they destroyed it.
It was awesome.
It was, dude, that castle was awesome.
I'd love to see Maz Kanata's ship.
Oh, right, yeah.
You know, let's see her ship. I bet it's crazy. She's a pirate queen.
Yeah.
She's a pirate queen. Let's see that thing. Donald Gleason.
Yeah.
Kelly Marie Tran. I bet she is going to kick butt. She
definitely is.
Yeah. Fire it up.
Yeah.
Fire it up. She is going to kick butt.
Oh, talk about romance. This is definitely going to be something with her and Finn.
I think so.
Rose and Finn in a tree.
Eunice Otamo as Chewbacca.
The Chewbacca.
The I played Chewbacca in the Star Wars. Yeah, Eunice Otamo. The best. My man. Eunice Otamo. You see Solo, you watched Solo already, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, man, I got that on digital. That movie just keeps on getting better and better.
Yeah, so far
I love it. I'm so glad it's out.
I still have seen it a total of 2 times. I can't wait for the Blu-ray. I just want to watch it on repeat and dig deep into those special features and stuff
like
that.
I know. They're out on digital, you know.
I know. I just, I don't know.
You're a Blu-ray. I'm getting both.
Well, the thing is, like, what are we, like, not even a week away? Like, I can, what is it, like, this upcoming Tuesday or something? Like,
it's coming out. Yeah. But, no, I'm excited. I already got the, we'll get that pop. We'll get the old Pacino action for you. Early Pacino. We only do early Pacino. We're going to do old Pacino, you know.
80s Joel. That's from Step Brothers.
I know what it's from. I know what it's from. yeah. So, Billy Lord coming back.
Nice.
Connix. Can't wait. Yeah.
And I love how much of a role she had in The Last Jedi. So, she's probably going to have like a pretty decent role
in
this movie.
I hope so.
Yeah.
I would like to see more of her. I think she's... pretty cool and compelling character.
Yeah.
Definitely. Jimmy V as R2-D2.
Okay.
Anthony Daniels, C-3PO, Greg Grunberg, Snap Wexley.
Oh.
Brian Herring returns to puppeteer BB-8.
Yeah.
But then we get to... Oh, we didn't even talk about this. Billy Dee. Billy freaking D.
Have you been following him on Instagram and Twitter and all that? Dude, he's like going to, he has a trainer. He was doing like,
oh yeah.
He was doing boxing and stuff like that.
Dude, he has the trainer to the stars.
Yeah.
You know, like Billy D is fighting in force now.
He's doing it.
This is the guy like everyone like gets in shape with,
mm-hmm.
you know? This is the man.
Well, he was like, you know, he was doing combos and everything. You know?
Oh yeah, definitely.
He still got it.
Yeah, he's gonna be cool. I can't wait.
It's gonna be great. You know something? I just want to see him in the Lando, like the costume. Just throw him in there. Give him his clothes back. Oh, dude! Imagine if he shows up in like Han's clothes, like at the end of Empire Strikes Back.
Jeez. Like he has Han's clothes from episode 7. Oh my gosh. That'd be amazing. That'd be amazing. Like, dude, why are you wearing Han's clothes
Get
all the time?
Out of here, you old pirate.
Oh man.
You got a lot of nerve. Dude, I almost
after what you pulled.
I almost said something to you like that through text today when you were like, dude, you ready? And I was gonna say, you got a lot of nerve after the stunt that you pulled.
Like, you would have made me feel bad. Yeah, oh, it'd be pretty. It's awesome. I'm so excited. So he's back. I can't wait.
JJ got the job and he was just like this. Call up Billy.
Yeah, it's his time. Billy, your time has come. It's time. I wonder where he was though. Wonder what he was doing.
I would love to hear all these conversations. You know what I mean?
Yo.
Like, how did that phone call go?
Yo. Lobot coming back? Mic drop. Is Lobot coming back? Billy D's there.
Imagine that. He's just like, boop, 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 boop. And he's like.
I want to see the reactivation after like 40 years. Yeah. The eyes open up. Oh my god, that's it's like a half a second scene, and everyone remembers it.
He's controlling a dude with his watch.
It's his best friend. They used to hang out and drink beers.
Well, that's maybe the tech. That was early form of texting, right?
That
there.
Was an Apple Watch, basically.
Yeah, exactly. Like yeah. He was just like, "We need help.
Let's go." Yeah.
Did he speak? No, I don't think he ever spoke.
No, there's a whole story. The first Lando miniseries in the
comics. He wasn't allowed to talk the first 2 years of work.
He had a personality. He gave it up to save Lando.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. Is Lobot coming back? I want Lobot in episode 9. Got to go through more of the cast here. We got even more to talk about.
Even more.
Yeah. And, you know, I mean, Lobot is, you know, on the table as far as I'm concerned now.
Imagine if Lando just went back to Cloud City. Like, if they're like,
why?
Like, hey, what have you been doing? He's like, I went back to work.
I'm in the union now.
Great Bennies.
No, well, I remember he was like, Lay asked him, was like, are you in the mining guild? He's like, no, not actually. So the guy's not a union guy.
Right.
Yeah, no, not actually. Oh, way to shut someone down.
A real
down.
Pirate. You'll like him.
Yeah. Scum.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. So we got some new people coming in. Kerry Russell. You familiar with Kerry Russell?
No.
Growing up, I always known her as the Noxzema girl. Because she was in a bunch of Noxzema commercials in the 90s. Then she was in Felicity,
okay.
The TV show, J.J. Abrams, one of J.J.'s
gotcha.
Early roles.
Yeah.
She was most recently in The Americans, which I hear is amazing. I haven't watched it.
I heard about that as well.
Yeah. Mission Impossible 3, another J.J. Abrams joint.
Yeah, did you ever hear of it?
Yeah. Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, 2014.
Heard of that as well.
Yep. Watched it. She's awesome. And she's in episode 9. It's confirmed.
Pretty sweet.
Who's she going to play? Some people saying Rey's mom. Other people saying Ahsoka.
Whoa.
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 Whoa. Whoa.
I don't know who she's going to play. I don't really care. I'm just, of course I care, but
I don't think they're going to touch Ahsoka. Do you?
I think it's a distinct possibility.
Really?
It would be super cool. I think so. I think there's some sort of crossover there. We shall see. We shall see. More people on the way, though. There is Richard E. Grant, who is a longtime British actor, who is pretty famous. He's done a lot. He's done a lot on the stage and on the screen. Doctor Who as well. He's played Doctor Who a couple of times. So we have another Doctor Who character here coming in. To compliment some other people who have played it as well. You know, like the Bendu, of course.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, what is it? Baker or something like that?
Tom Baker.
Yeah, Tom Baker.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, he was a moose. Big moose guy.
Big force moose.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's in the middle. He's the Bendu. I wanted more of the Bendu.
Me too. Yeah, and those rock crab things.
The rock crab things.
Yeah, I like
rock
those
crab
things.
Bendu. Bendu rock crab.
So is this? Can I see a picture of this guy?
Richard E. Grant. There he is. Some people were saying Thrawn, but I don't. I don't think so.
No.
He definitely looks like a First Order dude, though.
Yeah, he definitely looks like a bad guy. Now, he was a doctor.
He was one of the doctors.
So there's going to be two doctors in episode 9.
Yeah, Matt Smith.
Yeah, because, dude, how funny was that Terminator movie? Because they had him in it, and they set him up like he was going to be, like, the bad guy, and then, like, the movie ended or something like that, right?
Dude, that was Matt Smith.
No, it was.
In Terminator Genesis?
Yes, you can Google it. It was him. Because we both walked out of the movie theater going, wasn't that guy?
That wasn't Matt Smith.
Yeah, he had such a small role. He was like a background guy.
Really?
Yeah, it was weird, man.
I've only seen that movie once with you in the theater.
That was the last time I saw it.
Really?
It was.
Oh, wait. Yeah, you're right. There he is.
Yeah, he was like a guy in the background.
As Alex.
Yeah. Yeah. As person number two. Yeah, like he's a well-known actor.
Yeah, he played Skynet.
Exactly.
Yeah, spoiler alert.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
No one cares. That movie is pretty much forgotten about. Yeah, so pretty cool. Also from Lost Fame and Lord of the Rings, Dominic Monaghan.
I'm really excited about this one.
He's awesome. He's an awesome actor. J.J. Abrams' favorite.
Yeah.
Again, I think he's gonna bring a lot to whatever role. I definitely see him as a rebellion fighter.
Oh, he's definitely gonna be a good guy. Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. And you know, he's cool. I hope he's a Force user. I think he's gonna be a Force user.
He has likable qualities. Like I can't see him being a bad guy or like you know, like a guy in the middle, like a DJ type character.
No.
I can't see that.
No, I think he'll be back. I think he's going to be... So I have this whole idea that Rey's going to be training new Jedi, you know?
Okay.
I think they're going to be old and young, and they're not... You know, I think they're just going to be anybody who has the Force. I just have this feeling that he is going to be, like... He's going to be, like, a Force user that's being trained or already a Jedi in the years that have passed. And, yeah, I'm pretty excited about it.
Yeah,
you know?
Me too. That was a really great surprise.
It's
for
a solid
casting.
Solid casting announcement right there. You know, I actually don't know if it's an announcement. He said like, "Yeah, told ya," but
if you're a well known actor and also a huge fan of Star Wars, and you know, you made a phone call like, "Hey, JJ, I heard that you're working on Episode 9. If there's any room, just let me know," because actors do that.
That's true.
You know,
that's
because
true.
Paul Bettany did that with Ron Howard.
Yeah,
he was just like, "Hey." If you have anything for me, next thing you know, boom, main bad guy.
He is so good.
Yeah.
He's so good in Solo.
I wish we went to Rhode Island Comic Con last year.
Yeah.
He was there, but we knew next to nothing about Solo.
I know.
You know what I mean? Like,
I know.
You know what we should have just did? We should have just took a group picture with him.
Yeah.
That's what, you know, dude, we need to start thinking this out more.
Yeah, we really do.
Because last year, there was some bangers over there.
We missed it. We missed out on a lot.
Andy Serkis.
Yeah.
No pitcher.
Yeah. Frodo.
Yeah. Paul Bettany. No pitcher.
Yeah.
Elijah Wood. No pitcher.
Yeah, that killed me.
You know. Yeah, we spent all our money on Dolph Lundgren.
Hey, no regrets.
No, oh, hell no.
No regrets.
We're in his presence for what? Eight to 14 seconds, and it was excellent.
It was amazing.
And the picture came out awesome.
He's so large.
Yeah.
He's so large.
Yeah.
He's like, okay. I think that's all he said.
Yeah.
Hey, guys. Okay.
We're like, wow.
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 Yeah. We wanted to ask him.
A Kamino saber dart.
We had, like, for 5 months, wanted to ask him with a bucket of ribs.
We just,
it blanked.
Yeah, we froze up.
Yeah. Yeah, blanked.
When I got his autograph, I did have him write Good Journey, but then when I looked at it, he didn't write He-Man. No, I was just like, dude, this movie's awesome. And he was like, yeah, it really holds up. And I'm like, wow.
I know.
And that's it. That's all it takes for me to get thrown. I was just like, I walked away like, I was like, ghost face. Like, just like,
it's
wow.
So true. Wow.
My mom likes you. Wow.
Oh, man. Hey, all right. Yeah, we'll talk about it in a minute. We should do a little quick. All right, we'll do a quick NeedEm Gotem right now. All right, real quick, NeedEm Gotem this week. We're talking about Dryden Voss. Oh, sorry.
NeedEm Gotem time.
NeedEm Gotem time. Yeah. We're talking about Dryden Voss. They announced a 6-inch Dryden Voss.
Yep, Black Series, baby.
Black Series, baby. And new feature, we're going with scars that turn dark in the sunlight, UV rays. We're going Zartan.
I was just going to say, that's like G.I. Joe stuff.
G.I. Joe 80s Zartan.
Yeah, and they had...
Dude.
They also had like a zombie trooper. I don't know if you remember this guy, but if you put him in hot water, his face turned colors.
When was this?
It was G.I. Joe, but you know, it's when they started getting a little wacky. you know?
Yeah, 90s G.I. Joe.
Yeah.
But Zartan, one of the most amazing action figures ever created. You literally, like, put him on UV rays and he changed color. Like, you got, like, purple, like tattoos and scars and stuff on his face.
Yeah.
It was the greatest thing that's ever happened ever in the history of toys. And now it's coming to the Black Series. It's the thank God someone finally thought of this for Star Wars.
Well, this is the thing, too.
It makes sense.
I did hear this, but I wasn't sure. Like, nobody can confirm it.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
No. It could
you're killing
be.
Me.
No. But
you're,
I mean,
you're crushing me right now. I thought Yakface reported it.
Well, it could.
What is it? Only rumor?
No. I don't know. That's why. Oh. Like, I heard it and I was like, wow, that sounds way too good to be true.
Oh no.
Well, somebody.
Oh, no.
Somebody else said that. You know, like those. What are the blades called? Vibra blades.
The Vibra blades. Yeah.
They also said that I was going to have a light up feature, which there's no way in hell that's going to happen. If that happens, I don't know. I'll just scream for 3 hours.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So this is 8:31 on Yak Face. Rumor confirmed: Black Series Dryden Voss revealed.
Whoa. Rumor confirmed. Oh, rumor confirmed.
Oh yeah, rumor confirmed. Okay, my bad. Rumor confirmed. Yeah, it's pictures. Okay, so this is pictures from the Star Wars Underworld. Captain Phasma is coming to the Vintage Collection, and Dryden Voss is coming to Black Series. Voss's face scars will change depending on the temperature of the room. So this has confirmed. It was at Fan Expo Canada.
Yep.
And it's shared by Star Wars Underworld on Twitter.
Sweet, dude. That's awesome.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So, yeah. This is exciting.
It is exciting. Yeah.
Yeah. I can't wait. I mean, what a great feature. And it works so well for the character as well. Because his scars would change when he got warm, when he got heated up, when he got heated.
Yeah.
He got angry and his face scars would like light up.
It's almost like when you have
markings or whatever. He's not quite human.
When you have a crazy looking scar and you get a suntan,
yeah,
the scar isn't the same color as your skin.
No, but he's not quite human. So it changes whenever he gets like angry.
Yeah.
You know, he gets heated up and, you know, there it goes. They're more markings. They're scar-like markings.
That guy could never play poker.
No, not at all.
No.
Not at all. That's why he has Kira Arena. But reading the adaptation, the expanded edition novel.
Did I read it?
No, I've been reading it.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah, no. Me, you, me.
Me, you, me.
No, it's good. So, yeah, there's stuff in there. There's like bits, tidbits of info like that.
Residual bits.
Residually bits. As Oppo would say.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not good, buddy.
Oppo, Jerome Blake.
Hey, talk about Oppo.
Oh, hold on. We got to talk about Oppo? Okay, hold on. You were saying?
All right. So, I feel like before it was one of those things, like, we want to see an Oppo Rancis, the Black Series figure. But that was, like, wishful thinking.
Yeah.
Now we're getting into... All right, we're getting a Rio Durant Black Series, a figure with four arms. Now there is a huge rumor going around. Now, you know how they made the Gamorrean God, they made Moloch. This is a $30 figure.
These are like the premiums.
Right.
Yeah.
It's rumored that General Grievous is going to be getting made.
I know. Another four-arm figure.
We're getting
that body, that forearm body joint.
And the thing is, people aren't minding spending $30.
No.
So Hasbro,
I'll pick it up in a hot second.
They're seeing what's happening right now. I feel like it's a strong possibility that in the future we might see this character.
I think it's going to happen. Maybe we should get Steve on the show and really pitch this to him.
Well, HasCon 2019 is going to be happening at a perfect time because enough time is going to pass.
Yeah.
Right? That they'll be like, huh, we're going to take that into consideration because that could be a $30
figure. Already have the forearm joint body.
Right.
We can reuse that and just, you know, slap a tail on that thing, paint it green.
Yeah.
There we go.
And
put some beard on that.
Yeah.
We're good.
Put some beard on it. But,
put a beard on it.
You know, like that old school, like, snake, they, like, put a... It would be like a rubber material,
like,
and then
wire.
There would be
like
a wire in it.
They did like Globulus and G.I. Joe. Again, we're going back to G.I. Joe.
They could do that, and it would probably be cheaper than having two articulating legs.
Oh, yeah, definitely. It's just a wire. You know?
I think put a cloth cape, forearms, put
no
the beard.
Legs. Forearms, no legs, beard. It's there. Beehive beard, beehive head.
And I'll tell you right now, in our area, they won't be peg warmers because we're going to buy them all.
Yeah, we'll buy them all. Yeah. Again, we'll put this and the Willow figures side by side at our table down at the flea market down by the movie theater.
Dude, I'll paint my walls with the figure.
I'll build a house.
Right, exactly.
I'll build a house. I'll use it as a building material. That's it. Honey, what happened to the 401k?
It's gone.
It's gone.
Snake Man.
Snake Man took my money. Mm-hmm. We're running a little late here, but we gotta do it. Speaking of Oppo, we gotta do some Oppo Awards.
Oh yeah,
we gotta do some. We have to do them.
Oh,
we have to do them.
Yeah,
because they've been building up, Chris.
Really?
They've been building up. And you guys, if you don't know the drill. For all the newcomers here, Oppo Awards, this is your chance to become part of an exclusive club.
Exclusive.
Massively exclusive. You become an Oppo Award winner. We send you a patch, a very, very special patch. The only way to get it, is to leave a review on iTunes or Apple Podcasts, if you prefer, for Brews and Blasters. Make it good. We tend to like good reviews.
Yeah, those are nice.
They're nice, but, you know. Say what you want to say. You know, say what you need to say. As the song goes. Okay. So this one comes from Steve Addy Mundy. This show is wicked good. This is a wicked fun Star Wars podcast done by two fellas from the finest city in the world, Boston. Keep up the good work, dudes.
Perfect. You just got a patch.
That's
See,
it.
Guys,
you just got
that,
a patch.
It's that easy.
All you got to do after that, just let us, you know, send us the fact that you this is you that did it. And, you know, Brews and Blasters, retrozap.com. That's all you have to do. Send us your address. We'll ship them out. I have a backlog built up. We got to send them out. We ship them in batches.
Yeah.
You
done.
Know?
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
Give me half and I'll send them out.
Yeah, we'll do it. We'll have a little shipping party.
Yeah.
That's
at
it.
At the Whistle. A couple hundred beers. Let's go.
Chris, we went back to the Whistle a few weeks ago. We haven't even talked about food lately.
Yeah, we haven't.
No. I got that. That mac and cheese at the Whistle is calling to me right now.
Well, the thing is...
I've been eating straight trash lately. since the baby's been born, it's not been fun. Just straight trash whenever you can get it.
Well, it's meals you kind of just swallow now.
Yeah.
There's no more like, oh,
yeah.
There's none of that. It's more like he's sleeping.
Yeah. Like, really?
Yeah. I burnt my tongue again.
Exactly.
I ate too fast.
Yeah. Yeah. Did I eat? I don't even remember.
Right, yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Yeah. I've been buying microwave crap, you know, heat it up.
Yeah.
You know, I haven't been enjoying the spice of life, as it were.
Yeah. There's you know? No like, hey, let's slow cook the chicken.
Yeah. Oh, no. Pasta again? Okay.
Yeah.
Let's do it. Had some good pesto. I did have some good pesto.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, now we're talking.
Alexa makes like killer gravies.
I know she does. She's an amazing cook.
My grandmother had these huge... basil plants, and she just picked them all.
Madonna,
she gave
me.
Us a bag, a Ziploc bag.
What are you doing? One.
And she's just been banging out gravies with them.
That's nice, but you got to make some pesto with that, kid. What are you doing?
Oh, dude, we have bags. Bags and bags and bags of this stuff.
Can you sell me a bag?
I'll give you a big handful.
I mean, what I can do for you with a bag of basil. Trust, yeah. You haven't even had my basil.
Hey.
You haven't even had my pesto. My pesto.
We should have a pesto off.
Pesto off.
A bake off. Pesto off. I don't know what I'm saying.
I can just make some pesto that will blow
I'm
you.
I'm disappointing.
It'll blow your mind. Not to me. Okay.
The patch is amazing. If you guys haven't seen the image, I'm pretty sure if you just Google it.
Yeah.
Oppo
Award.
It's around.
It's a war. So, it's around. Yeah.
Yeah.
Look up hashtag Oppo. You know, it's around.
Oh. Oppo lives, whatever.
Yeah, Oppo.
Yeah, it's around.
It's around. Okay. Plo Kelm writes, a party indeed. Always have a blast listening to this podcast. The mix of Star Wars and nostalgia hits me right in the feels. Production value is done beautifully, and I love the soundtrack of the show. The show is on a break right now. Well, not anymore. Which has me realize how much I look forward to the pure love of Star Wars and the positivity the podcast delivers.
Nice.
Thank you, buddy.
Yeah.
It is the first show I recommend to anyone who asks about podcasts. Wow.
Wow, that's cool. You go
that's
down
huge.
As Super Dude.
Super Dude. Super Dude. It's true. It's true. All right. Last one of the night. You must unlearn what you have learned. Nice.
Nice.
That used to be the a sound clip to a hardcore song from a Boston band around a diecast.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It actually had a song called Unlearn. This is kind of in the... It was in the prequel era. I think it came out in like... Actually, it was before the prequel. It was in the like late 90s, you know? It was funny.
That's
so,
pretty cool.
Yeah, so you're like, heard that, and like, whoa, something Star Wars.
Yeah.
You know, it was pretty cool. Yeah, that, it actually endeared me to them quite a bit.
Sweet. Yeah. And then right to like Melting Faces.
Yeah. Then like there's a single, you must unlearn what you have learned. It was pretty cool. Anyways, George Starman writes, he's our buddy. He writes in all the time. You must unlearn what you have learned. 5 stars. These are all 5 stars, by the way.
Wow.
Listening to them, I learned so much about the movies, shows, books, toys, Gen X. Yet I probably learned more about the Boston area, sandwiches, seafood, beer, obscure cartoons, plumbing. I even began to add R's in words that don't have them. I don't feel like we add R's in. We take them out.
The only time that I add it, for some weird reason, I say Vodker. I don't know.
Vodka, yeah.
Yeah, Alexa calls me out on it all the time.
You add a G to monster, too. You go Mongster.
Monster.
I love it.
Oh, my God, I do.
I love that, though. I love it.
I never noticed that.
Hey, whatever. Let's,
I like it. I can't change
don't
that.
Don't stop. Spread the jam.
Yeah.
I love it. Yeah.
Hey, and I'm telling you, we still get some porcelain knobs to give out.
We still do.
You know?
We still do. We're holding one in reserve for Amanda.
Yeah. Oh, did she want one?
She won one. She said, hang on to it for us. We can ship it out anytime.
Oh, sweet, sweet, yeah, sweet.
Let us know.
Quality stuff.
High quality stuff here. All right. This is a good one. I feel like they're honest and opinionated, yet apart from a few comments about crappy figures, I don't expect they hate anything about the saga. Even when we hate a figure, we still love it.
Yeah.
It's true.
There's always something special about something.
It's true. We don't hate anything about the saga. We really love Star Wars. That's why we do this.
Yeah.
If we hated it, why would we do? Why would we spend our time
exactly.
doing this?
Exactly.
We love this. This is what we love.
We are Star Wars.
Okay. I lost my place there. It just floored me on that one. Oh, man. I imagine they do, but they respect the diverse opinions of the audience that they'll simply not mention things they hate. No, that's not true.
No, honestly,
that's not true, George.
Yeah, I love everything.
No, it's weird.
Yeah.
It's weird. It's weird. We actually kind of like talk amongst ourselves when we're not on the air. We're like, why don't we hate more?
Yeah.
You know, we don't understand when people hate things. I don't know. We love Star Wars that much. And we just happen to be friends, too. I've embarrassingly matured through my emails over the years. Nah, you always write great emails,
yeah,
George.
Good emails.
I've never felt judged by them. That's because we don't judge you. We love you, kid. Even when some of my emails got a bit wacky. Yeah, you know, we're a bit wacky, too. That's what we love about our listeners.
We're crazy boys.
Crazy boys. Congrats on the babies, and may the force be with you always.
Well, thank you,
buddy. Thank you so much, buddy. Yeah, that's the best. You know, we love Oppo Awards. We love giving them out. So you all win. You all got the job.
You got the job.
Send us your addresses, and we'll make sure to get them out. Yes, the time has come again to wrap up the show. Thank you so much, guys, for listening to Brews and Blasters. We had a great time this week. We hope you did, too. You know where to find us. Fan of the Tracks, Dryden News, Apple Podcast, Spotify, Stitcher, SoundCloud. I can talk to the microphone, man. It doesn't matter. You know where to find podcasts. You listen to one right now. What are you doing? If that's the case, you can hear us. And that means you can email us. BrewsandBlasters@RetroZap.com. BrewsandBlasters@RetroZap.com. Email us. Let us know your thoughts about Star Wars, about Episode 9, about roast beef sandwiches, about steak tips, whatever you want to talk about. We want to hear from you. BrewsandBlasters@RetroZap.com. What things are you drinking this weekend? Are you drinking bourbon? Are you drinking vodka? Are you drinking gin? We don't care. BrewsandBlasters@RetroZap.com. Or leave us a voicemail. Leave us a voicemail Saturday night. You get it out of the bars. voicemail, 978-219-6688. What are you doing? Let's talk Star Wars. 978-219-6688. Let's get weird. We're part of the RetroZap Podcast Network. Find every show on RetroZap.com. And don't forget about the network feed available on all podcast apps. Our official website is brewsandblasters.ninja. We have the .com, but why not put in .ninja? It's more fun. And we pay for it. Go there for show notes, post a subscription, and for one more. And if you want to support the show, we don't need a Patreon. All we need is an iTunes review. Helps more people find the podcast, and you win an Oppo Award.
Oh. Yes, 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 yes.
And while you're at it, let's do some marketing here. All you got to do is tell a friend about Brews and Blasters. Who are you with right now? Tell them about Brews and Blasters. You know, if you're at work, look to the person next to you. Take off the headphones. Say, hey, download Brews and Blasters. It's a good show.
Yeah, let's get wacky.
Let's go. If you're on the train, tell a stranger about Brews and Blasters. Just scream it out. Just scream, download Brews and Blasters. All right? We don't care. All right. The Collector's Hut. TheCollectorsHut.com. Chris is doing the figure reviews. It's amazing.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. All right, guys. You might want to buckle up, baby. Suck a lot. Tell it to Kanji Club. I'm afraid the party's canceled, but my summer's never shown.
Clutch.
Godspeed, Rebels!